Now, why that why we have separate out the LZ component and we have taken these two as combination. We can keep in mind that this is not necessary, but normally when we, for example, say that we apply the magnetic field in the Z direction. So the magnetic field application in the Z direction is not compulsory, but this is by just convention that we take the Z component as the direction of the magnetic field. So here we took these as a plane and this one is their direction. While we can take YZ and X is separate out, means the YZ plane, and we can define the L plus minus. Similarly, the X and Z can be taken as L plus minus, and then the Y component will be separated out. So it is not obligatory, but it is customary to do like this. So now we will go to some other relations like the eigenfunctions and the eigenvalues of these operators. Now we will discuss the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of angular momentum operator. We know that out of the angular momentum operator, we are having the operators Lx, Ly, Lz, the components, and then the combination of Lx and Ly, which is L plus minus, and we are having the L square operator. These operators we have studied so far, and we know out of these operators that Lx, Ly and Lz are not commuting with each other. So when they are not commuting with each other, it means they are not having the same set of eigenfunctions. We know that the L square commutes with L plus minus, which we have proved here that L square commutes with L plus minus. It means that these two will have same set of eigenfunctions. And also we proved about Lz that L square commutes with any of its components. So with L square, when I will take this one, so Lx and Ly will already be included in this one. And then with L square, I will have to take the separate form of Lz. So we will start with the eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of L square and Lz. And let's say we go to the eigenvalue problem, and we take that, let's say f be the eigenfunction. So if n squared applies on f, let's say it is having an eigenvalue f, eigenvalue lambda, and then f, and when Lz operates on this f, then we are having the eigenvalue is mu and f. As L square commutes with Lz, then it means they will have the same set of eigenfunctions. So we now start with this and we find some values here that two operators, when they will be commuting, then they will have the same set of eigenfunctions. For example, let me try one of it. That I apply L square on L plus minus f. F is a function, f is eigenfunction of L square, and L square and L plus minus commute, then L plus minus f will also be an eigenfunction of L square. This I can write, I can change their order as they are commuting operators. So L plus minus on L square F. this we can do for commuting operators because their order doesn't matter. So L plus minus here, and when L square operates on F, we get lambda F, and this is lambda L plus minus F. So it started with L square L plus minus F, and it ended with lambda L plus minus F. So if F is the eigenfunction of L square, and we are having an operator that commutes with L square, then that operator applied on a eigenfunction will also be an eigenfunction of L square. So now we start with L z. This was one of the step that we did. This is, let's say, step one. This is step one that we did, and now I go to step two, and in step two we find that what about LZ when it operates on L plus minus F. Now I have proved this one, that L square, that LZ and L plus minus are not commuting operators. So they will not have the same set of eigenfunctions. I can write this one, that LZ and L plus minus F, I can now not change this order because they are the non-commuting operators. But there is no mathematical harm in adding and subtracting the same thing from here. So let me add L plus minus LZ F with it and subtract the same L plus minus LZ F. There is no mathematical harm in this one. So now I can write that this is equal, this thing is equal to LZ and L plus minus plus, and if I add this one with this, minus L plus minus LZ, and I take F is common, and then plus this term L plus minus LZF. Then I can write that this is the commutation of LZ and L plus minus and F here plus L plus minus, and when LZ operates on F, we get mu F. The eigenvalue is mu. So this thing is equal to LZ and L plus minus. I have put here that this is equal to plus minus H bar plus minus H bar and L plus minus, and this one is plus mu times L plus minus, and I can take from both F is common. So this gives me that when this thing is equal to plus minus, means mu plus minus, mu plus minus H bar L plus minus F. And what we did that when LZ operates on L plus minus F, what we got? We got a new eigenvalue. This one is a new eigenvalue, that L plus minus F is the eigenfunction. and we are having that eigenfunction here L plus minus F, and it gives a new eigenvalue which is mu plus minus H bar. So this is like the L plus minus F is an eigenfunction, is an eigenfunction of F with an eigenvalue of mu plus minus H bar. So the I can write that L plus means when I take L plus, so I will take plus here. L plus is the raising operator. Why we call it the raising operator? Because it changes the value of Lz from mu to mu plus H bar, and L minus is the lowering operator because it changes the value of Lz by minus H bar. The eigenvalue of Lz is mu, so L plus changes it to plus H bar, mu plus H bar, and L minus changes to mu minus H bar. So this is a very good thing, is we have already experienced this thing in the simple harmonic oscillator, and we were having there A plus minus is the raising and lowering operators. So in step 3, we will discuss these ladder operators, these ladder operators, ladder operators of angular momentum states. So they are like the when we are having a function and the function is f, then we were having, this was the eigenfunction of the Lz, and it was having an eigenvalue which was mu. Now when on this eigenfunctions L plus operates, then it gives the eigenvalue is mu plus H bar, and when this operates again, so L plus in on L plus minus, so L plus minus square and F, and it changes the value to another H bar is added, so mu plus 2 H bar, and this will continue. Now when on this I operate L minus, when I operate on this L minus F, it lowers the value from mu, and it is mu minus H bar, and if I operate it again L minus on L minus F, so it will be L minus square F, and here I will have mu minus 2 H bar, and this will continue this way. So here this is the eigenfunction of Lz, and this is the eigenvalue of it. When I apply on the eigenfunction of Lz L plus, then it raises its value by H bar, and the step size is h bar, whether we go this way or this way. So it is increasing it and decreasing it, and we are going this way. So finally a level will reach that when we will apply L plus on this one, and let's say that level is that function or that state or that level is the top level, then the maximum value the LZ can take, we know that here our LZ is actually the ML values. So the maximum value it can take will be L H bar, while on the downward this minus is operating, and we will have the bottom state. This is the top state and this is the bottom state, and this will have the eigenvalue L minus H bar, L bar here I am writing on it in order to distinguish from this, and this will give us the final value of this. So this is the bottom rung and this is the top rung of this. And now we will go toward, we haven't yet found the value of lambda and mu. We are just sorting it out how to find it. So we will now proceed toward the these values. We will have to find these eigenvalues as well as these eigenfunctions. Now when I reach the top of it and I apply, means the top level, and on the top level if I apply L plus on the top level, then I know that there is no further level here and this will be equal to zero. The maximum value that L plus can reach on this eigenfunction is L H bar, and any L plus operating on the top will give us zero. Similarly, if I take the bottom state here and I apply L minus on this one, I will get zero here because there is no further state available here. So I will have to go on with these two assumptions. And one thing that I know is that when LZ operates on the FT, means the top rung, then I'm having the value is L H bar. This is the maximum possible value here and F T here. While when L square operates on F T, so for L square when operates on F T, I'm having the value lambda F T. So now I will have to find out this lambda, that what's the value of lambda with what's the value of lambda, means what this eigenvalue is.